These people are eating metal. Some of them can eat it without any immediate harmful effects. How are they able to do this? Is it even possible for your body to digest metal? Well, on today's episode, we're going to show you. This is your body on eating metal. Did you know that you're probably eating metal every day? If you eat steak, shellfish, or spinach, they contain forms of iron and calcium. Those are key parts of our diets as they help us form our red blood cells. There are also other forms of edible metal, like gold and silver leaf. But for this challenge, we're going to try something a little bit different. Instead of eating foods that contain metals, we're going straight to the source. Now, we don't recommend this at all, but what would happen if you tried it anyway? Before we start, let's look at someone who became famous for eating metal. This is Michel Lotito. He was a competitive metal eater who ate 18 bicycles, 15 supermarket carts, 7 TV sets, 6 chandeliers, 2 beds, a pair of skis, a light aircraft, and a computer. How was he able to do this? Well, more on that later, but for now, we have some metal to eat. You'll have to make sure that you don't choke on the piece of metal you're ingesting. Biting into metal is no easy feat. Even competitive eaters can't swallow their food quickly without choking. Michel Lotito used to cut his metal to eat it, so you should probably do the same. You'll also need to make sure that the pieces aren't long or sharp, as they can scratch or tear your esophagus and cause internal bleeding. Now, it's time to dig in. What happens next would all depend on what you decided to eat. If you swallowed a piece of an iPad or a computer, you would have traces of gold, aluminum, and arsenic in you. And if it were an older computer, it would contain lead. Now, luckily, a small dose of any of these metals wouldn't kill you. What you'd mainly need to worry about would be choking. But what would happen if you kept going? As the metal reaches your stomach, it would be unlikely that your stomach acid would even be able to dissolve these pieces of metal. The more you eat, the more it would start to accumulate in your body. You would eventually feel a sharp pain in your abdomen. This could mean that a metal shard has punctured your stomach. And these tiny fragments of metal could have even punctured your lungs and throat as they passed through your body. Okay, now it's time to sit on the toilet and get this out of your system. Most of it would pass through you, although extremely painfully. But even if you got the big pieces out of your body, you would still have small traces of lead, arsenic, iron, and a ton of other metals inside of you. If you didn't seek medical attention immediately, this would be very bad news for you. Okay, for the past week, you've had nothing but health issues. Having these small traces of metal inside your body would lead to all kinds of metal poisoning. The iron poisoning would make you feel dizzy and short of breath. Due to the arsenic poisoning, you'd be vomiting all the time and have red, swollen skin. Worst of all would be lead poisoning. It would start with abdominal pain. As more time passed, it would spread to your kidneys, and eventually, lead poisoning would destroy your entire nervous system and cause you to lose your memory. But if this happened to you when eating metal, how was Michel Lotito able to do it? Well, he had a condition known as pica. This means he was interested in consuming non-edible items, like metal, for instance. And with this condition, he had a much more resilient digestive system. This included a thicker stomach lining, thicker intestinal walls, and more intense stomach acid. So, despite all the things Lotito ate, he was never harmed. But you weren't so lucky. Eating metal would cause irreversible damage to your body. This challenge was an awful idea. What about a less lethal one, like drinking only Mountain Dew? Well, we'll see what that challenge brings on another episode of Your Body On.